You said you'd fill in for Dezzle, right?
A man never goes back on his word. Well, unless it's with the ladies.
But can you really do it?
Oh ho ho! You doubt me, huh? Come on, you've seen what I can do.
Yeah, but only because you practically forced it on us.
I said I was sorry. Jeez.
We get how strong you are, but what about the spiritual power of wind? You don't have to go back and get it?
Not to worry. The Shepherd takes those spiritual powers into his being. So there's nothing to worry about. Especially not with an able and handsome wind seraph like me.
All right then.
I won't let you down.
I'll see to it you don't. I'm a little surprised. You're quite knowledgeable about spiritual powers and shepherds.
Well, I am a well-experienced grown-ass man, after all. You know, you can always count on me.
Somehow I'm not so sure that I can.
I know this is real sudden, but there's something I want to ask y'all so I can fit in a little better. Tell me your weaknesses.
Why would we tell you something like that?
Hey now, that's cold, Mick boy. I'll tell you mine to make it fair. On days when the temperature is low, I get cold.
Yeah, because you don't wear any clothes.
Oh, I see how it is. You want something juicier? Let me tell you something. If a girl starts crying, there's nothing I won't do for her.
Didn't need to know that, thanks.
You guys are tough customers. All right, try this one on for size. I'm strong against earth, but weak against fire.
We knew that.
That's no good either. Well, then here's a juicy tidbit that'll rock your world. As far as I can tell, from the waist up, Lila is...
This isn't even about weaknesses anymore. Looks like you're fitting in just fine, I'd say.
Hey, Zavid. I want to ask you about something you mentioned.
Is this your response to my love confession?
Don't try and weasel your way out of this. You said there was something you had to settle with my brother.
That's all there is to it, really. There's just something between us we need to settle.
And that something is?
I told him, please, let me marry your little sister, and he punched me.
Don't lie.
Oh, come on, he'd totally do something like that.
Fine, don't tell me then.
No wonder he's worried about her all the time.
So what's this really about? Did Edna's brother ask a favor from you or something like that?
Who wants to know?
Does it have something to do with the oath?
Nah, it's not that big of a deal. But even so, a promise between men is just as sacred. It all might be too much for mere humans to bear.
I shouldn't have taken them along. Oh, it's so useless to say that now.
They could have stayed home in their rooms if they didn't want to deal with it. They went out of their own accord.
Yeah, and I don't think either of them expect or want anyone to take responsibility for their being dragged into this.
Both of them seem so used to living with the Seraphim. Wonder if they were always like this.
Saraya and I were raised together ever since we were just babies.
There was a time when you were a baby?
That's rude.
My bad. I'm sure you were a sweet, well-behaved little guy back in your day.
Too bad I'm not like that anymore, huh? You know, there's something I've been wondering.
Yeah, what?
You're an Earth Seraph, right? So why do you use an umbrella for a weapon? Isn't that more like a water element?
I guess I can tell you. Ready to have your mind blown? I'm using it precisely because I'm an Earth Seraph.
Huh?
You know about the dominant relationships among the elements. Earth, water, fire, and wind, right? Earth is stronger than water. Meaning that especially when using seraphic arts, you can increase your mana output by using the subordinate element as a catalyst.
What?
Just to let you know, Lila has been using wind-imbued paper, and Dezzle's pendulum has been using earth and minerals as their catalysts. The staff that you've been using is fundamentally an earth element. You'd have to be a complete idiot for using something like that as a water seraph, is what I'd like to say. But I'll hold back.
But you did just say it!
Well, if you've been using it as a way to train yourself, or a way to incorporate physical attacks on top of seraphic arts, then you're not doing it completely wrong, at least. The longer you live, the easier it is for you to choose to do what takes the least amount of effort. But if you really aren't satisfied and want to grow stronger, Then you're just going to have to do things the hard way, if you want to go beyond whatever ability you were born with.
Huh.
Anyways, you've been using your staff without knowing what it's for. Good job, dummy.
Ugh. Now what do we do? It looks like Heldolf wasn't in Glaivend.
Indeed. Were he near us, we'd surely have felt the strength of his domain.
I guess we'll have to search somewhere else.
But we'll need at least some clue as to where he is.
Agreed. I hate wasting my time.
Hiding such a large amount of malevolence shouldn't exactly be an easy task.
Malevolence, huh? I remember feeling an unusually strong level of malevolence before.
When was that?
Right after we fought earlier. It was when we were heading back to Pendrago from the Guinevere Shrine.
So, maybe southwest of Pendrago?
All right, let's check it out.
You guys really gonna go on such a shot in the dark?
Sounds like it's worth a look.
We've got nothing to lose.
If this ends up being a waste of time, I swear I'll stab you.
Yeah, I'll keep that in mind.
Domain. It's so strong.
Heldolf.
Whoa. Okay. Yeah, he's freaky strong.
This won't go like last time.
I certainly hope that it won't.
What do you mean?
Do you think it's coincidence that you've encountered Hellion's domains at every turn?
So what? This was all your doing? Is that what you want to say?
Is this your idea of being merciful?
Be on your guard, Saray.
Yeah, he's capable of anything.
So, how are we supposed to find out if this guy really did bind with Mautellus?
We'll just have to fight him head on.
You got a death wish?
If not that, then what?
Tell me something, Heldolf. Are you...
What's so damn funny?
You talk far too much. I am the Lord of Calamity, and thou art the Shepherd. The meeting of the two is, by definition, conflict. Do you not agree?
Sarai!
Here he comes, everyone! Return to work!
Go on, Shepherd. Show me what a vessel you are.
I won't be pushed over that easily. Return to work! Echo Step Rockwear! You know nothing! Multiple currents! Be gone!
Ready? Go! Endport!
Strong as the earth!
Behold!
We're definitely outclassed, but...
We got this!
Hard to believe you're the same rosy-cheeked youth as before.
We're making progress, but I got a bad feeling about this.
Wonder of wonders, I agree with you.
You like that?
Are you happy?
Huh?
Keep fighting like this, and you'll strike me down. Can't you feel it? Is that not what you truly wish inside?
What are you saying?
You yearn for it. You crave it. Would you drown in this fountain of ecstasy you have created?
Lila, it's time to settle this!
What's wrong?
Sarai, if you finish this here, can you be absolutely sure you will not regret it later?
That's right. Did we really come all this way just to smack old Kitty Beard around? Or was there something else?
As you know, to quell the Lord of Calamity is the duty of the Shepherd. That is not incorrect.
Is he challenging us? Do it if we can?
No.
The bastard's up to something.
Simone!
Yes.
Dispose of them.
An illusory arc!
Look out, everyone!
You're too late! Finally putting some effort into it. How long do you think your malevolence can isolate him?
For one of his strength, probably only about 10 minutes. I apologize.
It will do.
What have you done, Heldolf?
Get ready!
Don't tell me the tables have turned. Victory was close, yet now only anxiety and impending doom.
Sarai! Don't let your emotions waver. He's...
Lila!
Still you interfere?
Vethnus Mioma! Lila, Heldolf is trying to manipulate me while I'm still missing the full picture. Is that what you're trying to say?
At this rate, he's just going to keep needling me. I'm a plaything to him!
Saray, I understand!
You've got to help every...
You're not getting away!
Mishima!
Under him!
Burn! Burning strike!
Predatory flame! Burning fire!
Crimson flame!
Make it burn your soul! Fire!
We just have to find a weak point! Let's knock him back with a hidden art!
Burning shine!
Brilliant pressure!
Destruction! Underestimated me!
Pillars of Prey!
Brilliant pressure!
Pillars of Prey!
Destruction!
Brilliant pressure! Brilliant pressure! Burn!
Burning shine!
Destruction!
Burn!
What?
Burning shards!
Burning shards!
Pillars of pain!
Burn!
Destruction!
Brilliant crescent!
Burn away! Come forth!
Destruction!
Release my strategy! Brilliant crescent! Brilliant crescent!
Burning shards!
Predatory flame!
Underestimated, Mr.
Burn away! Predatory flame!
Destruction!
Pillars of flame!
Destruction!
Burning shot!
Burn!
Burning shot!
Pillars of flame!
Predatory flame!
Vermilion present!
Burning shot!
Under destruction! How warped it is to struggle so.
What?
Simone, release the squire.
At once. Ow! What on...
Prepare to see just what your resistance has earned you, Shepard.
No!
And that was his fatal mistake. Wasn't it, Lila? Beth Miss Mioma! Resist this, dumbass!
Do you really plan to slay her? A Seraph?
Killing is my business. Or did you forget?
Simone.
Very well. As you wish. What?
Rose!
Toying with you has lost its charm. Shepard Saray, work under me. Should we not bring this world back to the way it was, together?
What?
Walking a path alongside the Lord of Calamity can only lead to malevolence. Surely you-
And what is so strange about that? Malevolence will always be with us. It can only be dispelled by the scant few who hold the power of purification. Are you saying that's the way things should be?
Hellions only bring pain, to humans and Seraphim alike!
And so it is therefore natural to resist malevolence? Absurd. Shepherd Saray, I repeat once more, join me. For too long have the Seraphim been forced to fight the Malevolence. Too long have they been chained, toiling away at their blessings. Let us restore them to their rightful form as Hellions.
I refuse.
Then let us finish our battle once and for all.
I refuse that as well. This is not the time.
So you say. But one day you will discover it for yourself. The true nature of humans and Seraphim in this world.
No mistake. That bearded menace is connected to Mautellus. When we were trapped by his malevolence, I felt a presence.
But there wasn't even a trace of Mautellus back then.
Think about it. What if you were convinced you couldn't see something, but it was right under your nose?
It's something we see all the time and yet never notice.
This?
The ground?
You mean the Hellion could be using the continent of Glenwood itself as a vessel?
Right. There's only one guy out there who'd be capable of pulling it off.
But if that's the case...
Even if all this is true, is it possible to purify the land itself? If Heldalf were the vessel, it would make a lot more sense. But if the Earth is the vessel, why would Mautellus also be connected to Heldalf?
Let's find Mautellus. If it's true that Heldalf is connected to Mautellus, who's become a Hellion using the Earth as a vessel, then so long as we don't purify Mautellus, we'll never be able to quell Heldalf.
But even with all the legends of Mautellus we've collected, there hasn't been a single clue as to his whereabouts.
We should search for Maven.
Old Man Maven?
That's right. He was journeying to study the legends surrounding Mautellus as well.
We don't have a clue, but he just might.
Yeah, but... how are we supposed to find him?
I have an inkling. Let's go meet with the ones who protect the ruin of Logrin and see what they think.
Logrin? That's the ruin in Zafgot Moor, right?
Yes. Then it's been decided. Let's get packing, Meebo.
All right. Just stop that.
Hey, are you okay with this?
I trust him, though it is a gamble.
Let's do this!
Did you regret making Saray a shepherd?
Saray is an admirable shepherd. How could I?
Do you think he can win against Heldalf and Mautellus?
Tell us! Shall I read your palms?
Oh, you have girl trouble!
So it was that easy to tell, huh?
thought I'd see so many Hellions. Kinda makes me feel guilty for not being able to see them before.
You should. Ignorance is a crime, you know.
So, don't you think the quality of equipment is crucial in surviving tough battles?
They also say that true masters don't choose their weapons.
But since we're no masters, I thought it might be better if we build relationships with the shop owners and order from them.
Yeah, well, they say the relationship only lasts as long as the money does.
Yeah, I agree. So what I'm saying is, it's important to build the relationship with the shopkeeper rather than just haggling to get the price down.
I can't even tell if you guys are arguing or not.
Gotcha, Gold.
There we go! Info about an iris gem!
I wonder how long ago that was.
What? Getting one of your bad feelings, Rose?
You could say that. I haven't heard much about the village of Horsa lately.
This stone disease. Could it be a Hellion's doing?
That I cannot say. But I have a bad feeling about it.
You don't have to be Rose to feel it.
Sylphid is a heinous wind arc user.
They can warp, too. Don't take your eyes off them.
Leave it to me!
So tell me, how does love make you two feel?
I feel like I want this jerk to get away from me. Is that love?
Oh yeah, that's love for sure.
Love takes many forms. I see. Remove the ego from a love-hate relationship and what's left?
Must be hate!
How did it get so big?
I'm actually at a loss for words. Wow.
It looks like arts are effective. Let's divide the party up and attack.
Good decision. Shows how many battles you've been through.
Concentrate your attack!
Shield me!
Guard, run away! Return to flame! Together, don't know. Flames! Ground fire!
Snacks are done.
Hey there, Sarai. Young lady, you look well.
Glad we found you. Have you learned anything about Maltellus?
Right down to brass tacks, I see. Nothing much, I'm afraid.
Listen, Maven. I do understand this infringes on the taboo. But Sarai is the only shepherd we have right now. Please, I ask you to lend him your power so that he may walk his path without regrets.
Maven, you can really hear them?
Huh? What are you talking about?
Storyteller, we need you.
I see. So this man is the current storyteller of time.
Storyteller?
You must really be in a bind this time, huh?
I won't say we aren't.
I shall lend you my power. But you do know what that means, don't you?
Yes.
You're a scary one, lass.
Well, I'm lost.
Seriously. Lila. Maven. Can someone please explain what's going on?
Now, hang on a minute. Do you understand how momentous of a decision you're presenting me with here?
Wait a minute. Is this the taboo Lila mentioned earlier?
That's correct. But as an explorer, I'll give you a bit of advice. If it doesn't all add up, the sensible conclusion is that you're missing a piece somewhere. Also, relics are not only to be found in ruins. Remember that.
Are you talking about the Earth in Historia?
It's true, we only got bits and chunks out of those.
What is it you know?
For now, just search and trust your hunches. Everything else starts from there.
You never could give a straight answer.
I'll be sticking around here. Come back once you're satisfied in your search.
Got it. We'll be back.
Thanks a lot, old man.
What's that?
Why did she...
Rose, is the injury you got from him starting to hurt?
Oh, no, I'm totally fine. It's just really embarrassing for me to get hurt like that when being kept ransom.
No. What's really scary is that he would do such a thing without hesitation. And plus...
Simone's reaction.
Yes.
Her illusions are really something.
Her skills are quite unusual. But there's something even stranger about her.
You mean how she isn't affected by malevolence?
Yes. Or rather, how deeply she believes in him from the bottom of her heart.
But how could she? When she was shot, she was smiling. How could she trust him so?
Only she knows the answer.
But Simone has remained a seraph while following the will of Heldolf. That much is true.
So then what's really dangerous is how pure she actually is.
Pretty ironic.
Yeah.
Spherical perfection. You don't think it's Armadillin?
He said it was in Trizold Cave. Let's head on over there.
The storyteller of time, huh?
Hmm?
You knew about Maven too?
Well, you know, he just seemed like a storyteller to me. When I confronted him about it, it turned out my hunch was correct. That's all.
He's pretty well known as a storyteller. Especially among Seraphim who have been around for a while.
You could have told us about it, you know.
Well, it's also a taboo.
For both Seraphim and humans.
But what does that entail? Let's focus on collecting the Earth in Historia, Mikleo. Just hearing those stories probably isn't enough. So when you see with your own eyes, you can figure out the truth behind the myth, huh? That's what it's about. Isn't that right?
Ok,
Can't you give us a break on the medicine at least?
Sorry, I'm already putting my life on the line.
Hey, mister, don't you know that you're getting ripped off?
I know, but in this region, traveling merchants are the only people we can count on.
But 5 times the market rate is just too much.
There's a rampaging elephant in Zafgot Moor that is attacking merchant caravans. The danger involved caused the prices to skyrocket.
If it's just an elephant, aren't there plenty of ways to deal with it?
But it has wiped out many cavalries and armed troopers.
Definitely sounds fishy.
Could you possibly be the shepherd?
Oh, yes. My name is Saray.
Oh, my.
Your hope for this world.
Please, let us know if you need anything. I pray we can be of use to you.
Thank you. Just saying that means a lot.
I'm surprised at how pious they are.
That's how it's always been in Logrin. They must admire and respect the shepherd full-heartedly.
Even though they're in a state like this.
Isn't that where you come in, as the real shepherd?
Looks like it.
That's a funny thing they've got here. A doll inside of a doll.
Oh? You see them a lot in the north. It's folk art.
You don't think... Maybe it's meant to symbolize the relationship between seraphim and humans?
Whoa, I wouldn't go overthinking it.
But look, they specifically chose this odd configuration. There has to be some meaning behind it, don't you think?
Undoubtedly. So what would you say it means then, having a human inside of a seraph?
Well, maybe it represents the distinct personality inside each seraph? No, hold on. Perhaps, in depicting a fanciful inverse of the typical seraphim-human-vessel relationship, it's meant to symbolize coexistence between the two. Zavid, is there anything inside the innermost doll?
Yes. Typically in the very core is... a plumpet.
A plumpet? Yes, a symbol, of course. But of what? A pit is a seed, a sign of rebirth, perhaps? But then, why a plum? True, some bloom in the spring, but...
I'm starting to get why you like toying with our boy Mickey here.
I know, right? In some ways, he's even more pure than Saray.
Such rich philosophy. Very profound.